calibrating a ProSense pressure switch couldn't be easier. In this video, we'll do it in four simple steps. Step 1. Slide the cover down to access the set point adjustment nut. Step 2. Exercise the switch. To do this, increase the pressure from 0 to the full range of the switch, then return to 0 PSI. In our case, we would increase the pressure to 100 PSI and then drop back down to 0 PSI. We want to exercise the switch 3 times to make sure that the switch is operating correctly. Step 3. We want to increase the set point to 60 PSI. To increase the set point, we'll bring the pressure up to 60 PSI, hold it there, and then adjust the switch. Turn the adjustment nut clockwise until the light turns off. Now slowly, turn the adjustment nut counterclockwise until the switch turns on. Once the switch turns on, it is now calibrated to 60 PSI. Step 4. Test the switch by increasing the pressure to just below the set point. Then walk the pressure up until the switch turns on. Now slowly decrease the switch until the switch turns off. Be sure to test the switch 3 times for repeatability. That's all it takes to calibrate a pressure switch. Step 1, we revealed the adjustment nut. Step 2, we exercised the switch 3 times to make sure that it was working properly. Step 3, we calibrated the switch to 60 PSI. And step 4, we tested the switch to make sure it is activated at the set point. If you want to decrease the set point, it's just as easy. Step 1, slide the cover down. Step 2, exercise the switch 3 times. Step 3, we want to decrease the set point to 30 PSI. To decrease the set point, we'll bring the pressure up to 100 PSI and then back down to 30 PSI. Hold at 30 PSI and then adjust the switch. Turn the nut counterclockwise until the light turns on. Now slowly turn the nut clockwise until the switch turns off. Once the switch turns off, it is calibrated to 30 PSI. Step 4. Test the switch by increasing the pressure to 100 PSI, and then dropping it down to just above the set point. Then, walk the pressure down until the switch turns off. Now slowly increase the pressure until the switch turns on. Test the switch 3 times for repeatability. And that's it! Step 1, we expose the adjustment nut. Step 2, we exercise the switch. Step 3, we set a decreasing set point to 30 PSI. And step 4, we tested the switch. For set points on vacuum range switches, it is best to think of the set point as a negative pressure. So an increasing vacuum set point is a decreasing pressure set point, and a decreasing vacuum set point is an increasing pressure set point. Now that you know how to calibrate a ProSense pressure switch, you can incorporate them into your various projects.